I hate forms. I'd rather spend my time trying to figure out how to exit Vim than write another form in an application. Even if you use Formic or React Hook Form, there's always some sort of limitation, and figuring out how to get around that is painful. Houseform is a film-first, Zod-powered, headless, agnostic React library, meaning that you can use it with any of your UI or CSS libraries, and you don't have to worry about it overriding any of the DOM. You can use it with React, React in SSR, or you can even use it with React Native. So let's take a look at how Houseform performs. Let's start with how Houseform works, and then we can kind of build up to a really complex example. So here we have a form and field that's being imported from Houseform. The form wraps around your actual form, and then the field is everything that you may need, like username, passwords, email, whatever it might be that you're using for your application. As you can see here, we have a submit parameter right here that's just a promise that handles however you want to submit. So here we have a field. We've given it a name of username, and the initial value currently is nothing. Inside of that, we have these parameters of value, set value, and on blur. Then we actually just have our regular input here. This is just the standard HTML input, and we're setting the value to whatever the value is. On change, we're updating that value in the state. And then finally on blur, we could do something with on blur, but we're not actually doing anything. Down here, we have a submit that then does this promise, which would be a submit, and you can handle a submit however you want. Then we kind of notch this up a little bit. So let's take a look at what happens when you have values that you want to use. So here I have an actual form that we'll look at on the UI as well as just here. What I'm doing is I have a field here, which is an email, an onChange validate. So every time you update the thing, we're using Zod here to make sure that the email is an actual email. And underneath, we'll just keep putting must be an email until they finally finish with .com. Not the best example, but it works regardless. Inside of that, we have a div wrapped around our input. And our input here has a value on blur, and then on change, we're doing the exact same thing. Then down here, any errors that do show up will show up as a P field. And then this is disabled if it's not valid, and it must be valid by using this onChange validate. So let's look at this in the web real quick. So here we have a form that I've really zoomed in at. It says email and it has a submit. And as soon as I enter this field and start typing, you see it must be an email. So if we do jamesperkins@hey.com, it then switches off as soon as it's valid. And obviously, as soon as there's not an ending, it must be an email, so that you can provide all of these error messages without having to pass in a bunch of state. And it's all field based. So the more fields you have, it only worries about the field that you're actually in and can validate before you submit. So let's look at the final example, which is a login form, which has fields and we can check to see if it's validated, all sorts of things. And I'll show you the real power of Houseform. So here we have the form again. Same thing, form and field, that's the basis of Houseform. Here, we're sending an alert and we're checking to see whether or not they're submitting or they're validated. On submit, we're gonna try and submit using this submit hook, which is a promise. In here, we have a field. On blur, we're validating to make sure it's an email. And then on submit, we're making sure that this email is valid. So we have two validations here. One, on blur, so when they get out of that, we need to check to make sure it's valid. And then on submit, we need to make sure it's unique. This could be a login form, so you kind of get the idea. You want a unique email address. You don't want them trying to sign up again. In here, we have an input. We're setting the value to the value. On blur is on blur, which will do this validation. On change, we'll set it to the target, and then the placeholder will be email. And then underneath will show all the error messages. Then we have our password here. It's got to be a string and it must be a minimum length of 8. If it's not, again, using Zod means that we get to do great validation and great error messages. So we'll show this error message must be at least 8 characters long. Down here, we have the input. Same thing, we're doing the errors. And then we have our confirm. And what we're doing here is listening to this password field. And then we're making sure these equal each other. And if they don't, we go ahead and tell them that the passwords must match. And then finally, we have this button that will be disabled unless everything is valid here. So let's go ahead and test this one out and see what it does. So here we have our form again. Let's just type in my email address. And then let's type in a password. So let's try 5 letters. So as you can see, it's got to be at least 8 characters. So it tells us that. And down here we have password must match because I tapped into the field. So let's do... Now we have a valid form. If I hit submit here, so it says that email is already taken. I actually put a piece in the bottom here that says, is this email unique? So we were checking up against our database and I put my name in as the beginning of an email to kind of simulate that I've gone and checked in my database or wherever I'm storing these users. So let's go ahead and try a different one. Let's just try James at hey.com and then hit tab. So now this is validated. If we hit submit now, so the form has been successfully submitted and I'm simulating that by throwing up an alert. And you can see that everything is in key and value points. So confirm password, password, and email are all things that are easily managed on wherever you're sending this data. So there you have it, a first look at Houseform. If you're interested in Houseform, I put a link in the description. If you made it all the way to the end of the video, YouTube is going to recommend a video over here. Go ahead and click that. And if you're not subscribed, make sure you click the button. I'll see you in the next one.